don't have anything good to say, or that you are too fragile to speak out, think again. I think that a lot of us believe that we were not able to advocate for ourselves, or that what we had to say was not important. So we have relied over the years on a lot of other people to do the talking for us. We are really lucky to have a strong community of advocates fighting for us to make sure that we get the services we need. However, at least for me, my perspective of what it is like day to day to live with a mental illness is sometimes different than the perspective of my allies, the people around me who love me and support me. They walked beside me through my journey, but they didn't actually know firsthand what it was like, what it felt like. And since those of us who actually live with mental illness are less apt to speak up, that's the part of the story that is not represented at the table. The gist of my message to you today is twofold. First of all, we are living in a time when the rights of people living with mental illness are in jeopardy. And two, we can't assume that our unique perspective is being expressed. And we also can't assume that someone else has the whole advocacy thing covered for us. Now the tricky part here is to figure out, how do we get a seat at the table? Well, one of the things that you can do is call an advocacy organization and find out ways you can contribute. Also, my organization runs the Ambassador Network, and there's information cards at the table in the back there. Or you can talk to me afterward today. And when it comes to finding a seat at the table, our allies can help us too. If you are a family member or a friend, and you are involved in mental health education,